Moreover, it leads to family disputes that impact the well-being of the citizens. And the family disputes are starting from, you know, silly processes, such as when you divide the land, you have a pre-mutation sketch, you say the north part of the land which has got a well is to the elder brother, the south part is to the younger brother. When they actually take position, they interchange the land and they build up a hut on both sides. And then when they want to sell, they figure out that the property deed says something else. So it's as fundamental issues such as these which leads to disputes. The support system is critical that facilitates smooth land acquisition for developmental projects at appropriate rates and with appropriate compensations. And we're all familiar with this point if you're following the newspapers and what's going on in different parts of the country in terms of land acquisition. The revenue impact is the most significant part of it. The intermediaries such as brokers charge a disproportionate amount to connect property buyers to sellers. That can be eased out. The right market price of the properties can be figured out. Such charges also increase the transaction cost and hence limits the resale of properties, thus depressing the market. If every time you do a transaction, there is a huge cost of transaction because the brokerage, taxes, and so on and so forth, you'll do less of those transactions. If you do less transactions, the market is depressed. If the market is depressed, the value of the land is depressed. If the value of the land is depressed, the state GDP stays depressed. If you put in a system which takes these issues out, the state GDP is estimated to jump up by 10 to 12% in a single year, if all of this can be implemented in 1 year. So there's a proposed land and property exchange system that we have put in. I will not go into the details again because we don't have the time for it, so I'll just skip and move forward. There has to be a complex linkage with the clearing banks and how the loan process happens and so on. So I'll come straight to what the benefits therefore are. So what we therefore get at the end of the day, because you're able to transact land sitting in your room or going to a common service center or to a Bangalore One center and doing your transaction rather than running around from post to pillar, is that you get a service-oriented administration. As of now, we've got a tax-oriented administration, which is that our entire focus is on how to maximize the revenues from taxes. However, if the government starts looking at providing services and getting a revenue enhancement because of the service provided, and in this particular case, the service of putting the buyer and seller together and then ensuring there's a smooth transaction that happens, I'm sure citizens will be willing to pay that 1 or 2% extra to the government rather than paying it to a broker. And that increases the revenue that is collected by the government. Also, because the transaction cost goes down and the hassles goes down, the number of transactions goes up. If the number of transactions goes up, again, the tax collection and the service revenue collection goes up significantly. So there is a huge impact on the revenue collection, which leads to the revenue enhancement. There's a reduction in litigation and frauds, which unchokes the courts. The increase in value of property and land, ease of land acquisition for projects of public interest, because the visibility to the clear title of each of the land is there. What is happening right now is that villagers claim that this is their land based on nothing, because they have been staying there for a very long time. And it's a valid claim, but how do you really test that claim? Can you take it to the court of law and say, this piece of land is owned by this villager because since last 200 years, their family has been tilling the land? You can't. And therefore, what's the way out? So once you clean up these systems, then these solutions start coming out, and therefore, the ability to acquire land for public interest becomes that much easier. And finally, also, it leads to easier access to bank funds because a bank has got visibility to the clear title of the land. However, it's not as simple as just putting in a system, putting some code, putting a layer on top of the existing system on top of Mojini and Bhumi, and it'll be up and running. It doesn't happen that way. There are many detailed issues. I will not go through all of them. But at a high level, we need to have people training. We need to have legislative changes. We need to have administrative changes. And we need to have training of owners on how to manage their digital signature and how to manage their digital ownership of land and so on. I'll just leave this with one single thought on what are the legislative changes required. One of the key changes that will be required are three rights that the government should be able to grant. One, the right for owners, so grant owners a priori right to sell properties where the government has no objection. So if that is given, then you know which one has a clear title. So this in a way translates to a clear title. B, buyers who qualify on terms such as eligibility to buy agricultural property, a priori right to buy land. You'll find it strange that in many cases you will go and buy the land and then you're told that by the process laid out by the government, you're not a farmer, therefore you could not have bought that agricultural land. So your money invested gets locked up. And then there are changes that keep happening every year. If your monthly income becomes above 5 lakh, then you're no longer eligible to become a farmer. And that's strange. So these rules keep changing. And then you would have bought a land, and by the time you would have bought a land, your income tax that you would have filed is above 5 lakhs, and suddenly you will find that you can't own that land. You bought the land, but you can't own the land. So these are fundamental changes that need to be brought in. And there are many such changes. These are the key ones that I'm laying out. An automatic mutation of property after a certain waiting period. If after 1 month nobody has an objection to your registering that property and then mutating it, it should get mutated. Why should it wait for any more time? And that will solve a lot of the problems that we're talking about. So with that, I'll stop over here, and thanks for a patient hearing. If you have any questions, I'll be willing to take that. Thank you.